This is something like sharing gospel. When you preach gospel to the people who are Christians, it is easy for you to explain things. It is just like sharing gospel in Jerusalem. But when you go to Samaria or to the neighboring towns or people like that, maybe when you say that in the Bible it is said, they say, we don't believe that the Bible is true because, you know, you have manipulated Bible and things like that. But that is not a fact. That is not a fact. Bible is not manipulated. Sometimes people say there are many differences in Bible. One portion is different from the other portion, and some places the story is repeated, things like that. There are contradictions in the Bible. Sometimes even I get emails, 100 contradictions in Bible. What do you say about it? I said, that is the reason why I believe in Bible. Why? What are you saying? Because there are contradictions, you believe that Bible is true. I'm telling them, you are saying it is edited by somebody, or, you know, somebody has manipulated it. But if somebody was there to manipulate or edit, then they would have been, you know, rectifying all the contradictions. You understand? I was an editor for a magazine for 8 years. I started a magazine when I was 16 years old, and I was the editor of that magazine for 8 years. You know what I am doing? I am rectifying all the errors of the manuscripts when I get it in my hands. I am editor. I am rectifying all the errors in the articles written by other people. But when in the case of Bible, there are some contradictions in the human eyes. Somebody had to edit it. Somebody like me, if I am getting that Bible, I would like to rectify all those errors. But when I look at my Bible, I'm feared of touching it because it is God's word. So if you say there are contradictions in the Bible, that itself shows that it is not manipulated by man. Hallelujah. The Bible is God's word. So it was easy to give your faith or proclaim your faith in Jerusalem. Judea also it was okay, but when you come to Samaria, it is difficult. But when you go to the Gentile world, when you say according to the Bible, and the hearer, they say, hey, what did you say? Bible, what is it? When you say Jesus said, Jesus, who is he? In India we face the same problem. Many of the people do not know the name of Jesus. Once I went to a village, there was a man who was making the musical instruments. I tried to share gospel with him. I was just asking, do you know Jesus? No, sir, no. And I have my missionaries with me. Hey, why he is saying like this? Because the town is only 5 kilometers away. Why he says he have never heard about Jesus? Again, I was asking, don't you know Jesus? Are you sure that you do not know Jesus? He told me, I do not know, sir. And I was asking, is it true that you are saying that you do not know Jesus? And he was asking me, why, sir? Why should I say lie? I do not know anybody called Jesus in this village. I don't think he is staying in this village. I do not know anybody called Jesus in this village. I don't think he is staying in this village. He thought I was seeking somebody who was staying in that village. One of our missionaries went to a village. In their language, he was asking, Tumhe malum hai, Isu ke baare mein kuch malum hai? Do you know something about Jesus? And he was calling other people. Hey, you come here. Do you know about Jesus? And he called another person. And finally, they were discussing. And then they said, yeah, he was here, but his wife gave birth to a child and he went to his wife's village. They were not joking. They have never heard the name of Jesus. Sometimes people ask, what kind of vegetable that is? Because in those villages, only people from outside are coming only to sell vegetables. But you know what Jesus says? You shall be my witness in Jerusalem, where you will be welcomed by people. You need to go to all Judea, where it is easy to share gospel. You need to go to Samaria, even when you are not welcomed by them. But also you need to go to places where my name have never been heard. That is why it is a global project. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God wants you to share him. God wants you to be a witness of Jesus, not only in Jerusalem, not only in Judea, not only in Samaria. But God wants you to be a witness of him to the places where the name of the Lord have never been heard.